Hello everybody, welcome to Friday Night Stand Firm. I'm Jimmy Ventura and in the booth with me is Gorilla Mezzo. Hello.
Hello everyone, happy Friday to you. We are just two shows from shoving some money right up Jim's ass. That's right, 2 weeks away from the pay-per-view Money in the Ass. And we're here tonight with Friday Stand Firm. A lot of spots on that pay-per-view are still up for grab, and we are going to start off this show with one of them. That's right, Fatal 4-Way Table Elimination Match. This is going to be nuts. Gedanek, Satterfield, Calcium Kaz, and Dave! Ow, fuck my dog. Ow, fuck. She just jumped up and clawed my shoulder. Ow. Thanks for that. Dave got me cut there.
You gotta be amazing,
but that's
guys.
Right. Four-way table elimination match to seize a spot in the main event of Money in the Ass, the Money in the Ass contract match. And if you don't know the stipulation on that one, it is a ladder match. Or sorry, eight-person ladder match. And the winner of that will get a contract that they can cash in for either the extra arms belt or the World Heavyweight Championship for a shot at that title. And, oh, man, we're going to be splitting it half from Claw, half from Stand Firm. And let us get to ringside as we look for the third entrant from Friday Stand Firm.
Yep.
Yeah, fucking Claw, man. Jeez, it's got to be banned. Went right through my AV9. There he is, Satterfield. Had a hot start to this revival of Friday Stand Firm, but has cooled off since, failing to retain his WemDope title from Night Demon and failing to reclaim it either. Satterfield's looking for a new avenue to pursue, and could it be the world title or, the extra arms belt championship? Well, he'd have to go through a lot to get it, but he is there, and he's got a shot.
Yep.
But standing in his way is this man coming right out of the ramp. Calcium Kaz, one half of Rage Milk. We know what he's capable of, and he's going to be capable of doing it to Satterfield and two other competitors in this one. Of course, this match is a four-way table elimination match, means the only way to be eliminated in this match is to be thrown through a table, and the last man standing will get that spot. And we know that could lead to all sorts of brainworms. This match could be about 18 hours long, folks.
Yeah, it sadly could be, yeah.
Reinforced ladders, Stibum.
Anything could happen, and probably will.
Indeed. Of course, the master himself, Marcel McDaniels, one of the famed table competitors in the JFW, was actually offered this spot in this match. But he said he has been trying so hard to get the Marcel McDaniels Open Challenge going that he would prefer to waive his spot in this match. Nick doesn't have music.
He does.
Oh.
He's a real American.
Ah. Gotcha. Okay, I see. My bad. Anyway, Marcel McDaniels, of course, passing on entering this match, and instead will host the Marcel McDaniels Open Challenge later on tonight. That should also be a wild one. But shocked he didn't want a shot here for his debut, his return debut.
Yeah. Great to see Howdy Nick, the real American.
Most innocent man in Among Us.
Yes.
The most diced man in Blood Bowl.
Yeah, that's a recent revelation, isn't it? No, he's the luckiest.
He's the luckiest
Dice Lord.
Yeah,
in
the
Blood
luckiest,
Bowl,
yeah. I was building to that. No, Pettimu, he's doing it in the ring. Marcel McDaniels will be in the ring. hosting an open challenge match one-on-one.
Yep, definitely.
You would have needed my approval for that, Tibum, and I would have denied it. I don't know what you're talking about, Petty.
Amazing.
And there he is. I'm not going to do it again so my dog doesn't attack me. It's Dave! Dave had a hell of a showing in one of the other qualifying matches, but not able to seal the deal and lock in that spot.
Yeah.
Of course, the two other competitors to qualify for Mud in the Ass from Friday Stand Firm are The Waitrix, who we will see in action later in a trios match, and Try. That's right, folks. Try. Could his tag team partner, Gdenek, also make it into that match? That would be something. Would their friendship be able to survive contact in a match where they would not be tag team partners?
Yeah, and I think Claw has two furries in Volkvigor and Chunter, I believe, have qualified from Claw. But, you know, don't quote me on that.
They have Volkvigor and Chunter. Chunter, of course, qualifying last Monday, and Volk the week before. Who is going to be in... From tonight's pairing of four, we had been doing eight-man over the tops. We're mixing it up now with these table elimination matches. Let's see how this one goes. Of course, we've got two teams pairing off here. Howdy Nick getting worked over by Satterfield. And then outside the ring, Calcium Kaz not putting up much of a fight right now against Dave. But here's the counter on. Oh, no. Bounces off him a bit.
Oh, he's wrecking Dave.
Now he is. Yep. It was only a matter of time there. Of course, educated feet of Calcium Kaz.
Yeah.
And he's going right for that table. Wants to get someone out of this mess as quick as possible. Forgot to set it up, though.
Nobody can do everything.
Well, wow. We've watched Calcium do most of the work in his last outing with Flicky Flax, so he is used to having to carry more than his own weight.
That's true. He is a bad dude.
He is, in fact, a bad dude. But Satterfield has just cleared the ring, and now he was pointing at Kaz. Looks like he's going after him, and he sure is. Oh, but Dave taking them both out.
Kaz fighting them both off.
Yeah, you might think of Calcium Kaz as the most dangerous person in this match, but Satterfield, probably, arguably, the most successful of any of them, as he and Nick are about to face off over this table here. And now both tables are in the ring. That could be two eliminations if they think to set either of them up.
Oh, well, that's asking a lot from these competitors. Oh, here we go. Satner's got one.
Yeah, well, he hasn't set it up yet, but it looks like he's thinking about it in the corner here, and he has. Could Nick be going for an early exit here?
Boy, howdy. Hello, Night Demon. Oof.
And Nick in all sorts of trouble here. Satterfield setting him up.
Vicious chop.
Oh, but he needed a little sit down. Has a little sit-down meditation. Is that going to be enough? Nope, needed a second one there. Yeah, standing up from the first one wore him out a bit. And Nick able to capitalize outside the ring. Dave having a little sit-down, I think enforced on him by Calcium. No, Night Demon, this is the opening match of the night. Marcel McDaniels' in-ring return will be later on tonight.
Oh, I'm muted. I've been muted for ages here. I've just been talking away.
That's rare.
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, this is the first match because we managed to start right on time at 9:15. Way.
And Dave, look at Dave taking over here. Dave and Satterfield about to square off, I think.
If they can find each other. Oh.
Yep. Oh, look at this. Winds up into a huge uppercut, and he just put Satterfield out. And that could be the end of Satterfield. Look out. No, Satter with the counter. But here comes Calcium Kaz looking to get some revenge on Dave, I think.
Oh!
Oh! Nearly, I thought he was going to put him through with that for a second, but he didn't.
It would have been incredible, wouldn't it? Oh, man.
Oh, where's Nick going? Nick's going to fly here.
Oh!
Oh, missed. Comes up empty.
He missed because Kaz was hitting him with the table.
Yep. Both Calcium and Satterfield in a bad way right now, and Satterfield in a really bad way takes the chop against the table. Is this going to do it for him?
Oh, big boot.
No, the running knee by Dave might have just saved Satterfield.
Unagi. Oh, and now Nick has the brain worms. Oh, this
now
could
Satterfield
be curtains for Satter.
Yeah. Once more into the table, and this looks like it. Satterfield,
no!
And it's back down to the bottom, and Satterfield's run, if ever there was an exclamation point to say it's over, it's over.
Don't say it's over.
Well, you gotta get to the top to reach the bottom. I think that's how the phrase goes.
Yeah, something like that.
Something like that. Howdy, Nick, with the elimination. But there's still two men to contend with and only currently one table available.
Yeah.
But it not being set up, no one in true danger right now. Dave might just be realizing that. Nope. Calcium lost focus and is paying the price for it. Oh, look out. Hangs him up on the ropes. Here comes Gnanic, though.
Dave just dominating right now.
Absolutely. Oh, what a kick, though, to the side of the head by Nick. Can he get another elimination? He's got to get that table set up correctly. And I worry they're unaware of the existence of that table, given the position it currently is in.
Yes.
And this is where the magic can happen, folks. Another Uranagi.
Yes, I might have to take control here if they don't touch it for a while.
Ah, they'll get there. It always fixes itself in the end. Calcium's on it. Calcium's on it. See, look at that. Oh, and he's paying the price for it.
Oof.
Nick going to set it up properly in the corner. Nick going to not set it up properly in the corner.
Vicious chops, though. Oh, boy, howdy.
And Dave has just dropped everyone in the ring here. Can he get that table up? No, Calcium with the quick counter. Calcium was going for the low blow, but he got caught by a knee and out and bleeding profusely from the head as Nick fires up and knocks him out. But he needs a table. He needs a table. He needs a table. Nick really needs a table. He's looking everywhere for one, really thinking about where the best place he could get a table from is. And he is deep in thought, folks, wondering where he's going to get that table to maybe end this match. And he is still thinking about it as Calcium comes. Oh, my goodness, Calcium from out of nowhere. Oh, no, Nick countered him. He was playing distracted there to catch Calcium out.
Oh, my God.
What strategy by Nick? Oh, and he's looking for that table. What again? Is he gonna set up Dave? No, Dave. Dave was ready for his tricks that time.
Oh dear. Oh, there we go. Kick to the chops.
Oh, crane kick.
No, Dave.
Oh, and everyone teaming up on Nick now.
Wow. Oh, my God.
Didn't even get to play wrestling.
It's true, yeah, no, Dave. He's had more brain worms alive than he ever did dead.
Calcium now having trouble finding a table of his own, even though there's one right in front of him.
It is under the ropes, though, isn't it? It's under the ropes. Maybe that's problematic.
Maybe, maybe not. We'll have to wait and see. Look out. Oh, beautiful maneuver to Dave, but again, can't pin him to win it. He's got to put him through a table, and part of putting him through a table is knowing that tables exist at all.
Yeah, I think in this universe, they might all be allergic to tables.
Maybe.
Oh, devastating.
Big back body drop on one of the hardest parts of the ring. And Dave shrugs it off and gets the counter, wrenching the arm. Oh, but the chin buster in return. Calcium taking it to Dave.
Dave. Oh.
Nick thinking about a table, maybe. Nope, maybe not. Maybe Nick really, really considering his options here.
Oh, God.
This is perfect.
I think I need to take over. This is.
I don't think you know what you're talking about.
Okay. Okay. This is perfect.
Yeah. This is exactly what you expect out of a wrestling competition.
Yeah, this is fine.
And look at that. All competitors back in the ring now. All they need to do is slightly nudge that table and we'll be okay.
Oh, dear.
Oh, look out. Nick with the big snap suplex.
I hope we don't have to bump the Marcel match for time. That would really suck.
All right, Nick very strategically getting his brain. Yeah, it's possible we might need
it. Yeah, I think so.
All you need to do is have Calcium run into that table, and I think we'll be okay.
All right, let's have a look at this.
Here we go, everyone. We're having some technical difficulties right now. Stay with us. And the real funny part here is, does Jim know how to control? Clearly, look at this. Oh, you're being him. Okay.
Yeah.
That could be enough to do it.
Yeah. That could be enough. Right, let's go. Let's hope that's enough.
And here we go, folks. We've reset a little bit here, and Nick right in there. Oh, God. Somebody pick up that goddamn table.
Yeah, it's instantly back under. Oh, God.
Wait.
Yes!
We're good to go.
Glorious.
And here we go, folks. We never had doubts. G'day, Nick knows what to do with this table. But it looks like Calcium knows better, sending him right into it. And Nick in all sorts of trouble there. Oh, no, but it's Calcium who might be the next one through. If Dave can just pick him up and put him through it, that's going to spell disaster for Calcium. No, he fights back. Wild hook there to get control. Now Dave bouncing off that table.
Boy, howdy. Oh, wow. Middle
rope. Long way to go for Calcium.
Yeah, you don't see a lot of aerial action from Kaz, but wow, what a move.
Got it that time. Looks like he might have hurt himself, though, and here comes Nick. Calcium sent into the corner now, and here comes Nick. Oof. Nick gonna punch him or chop him. And Dave now with a real shot here to chop Nick. Oof. Again, not remembering that you need to put him through the table, not just lightly against it. A And now, Dave, dangerous moment here, folks. The excitement in full bore, and this is it. Dave!
He's
Dave going through that table, and that's two tables now. And now we're down to Calcium and Howdy Nick. Of course, Nick's partner, Try, already qualified. Could we get both of the tentacle-loving weebs into the Money in the Ass contract match? And here we go. Calcium knows he needs to get Nick while he's weak, needs to find himself a table. Look, there's one over there that everyone overlooked. No one noticed that table previously.
Now
Calcium's got it. But can he set it up and put Nick through it is the question.
It's going to be exciting to find out, isn't it? I can't wait.
Oh, running knee in the corner. He's right on top of the table. Does he notice it? Those tables kind of blend in.
He's got it.
And he's setting it up, and now Nick in all kinds of trouble. Table right in the middle of the ring. Could one half of Rage Milk be qualifying for Money in the Ass? Will we see some Rage Milk in the ass, baby?
Maybe.
Oh, sends him into the corner of it, and that might have winded G'day Nick. And here we go, folks. Nick very close to dangerous. Oh, look at that. Springboard kick to the side of the head.
Calcium's pulling out all the stops tonight, isn't he?
He is, absolutely. And he's bleeding profusely.
He might
and
have
now
Nick.
Nick. He might no. have him. No, Nick falling to his feet. Is Calcium going to be able to get him up and through that table? Bends him over it this time. And here we go. Oh, no, he might have moved it. He might have moved it.
Oh,
it
no.
didn't break. The table didn't break.
No.
Nick is still in it. The luckiest man in Blood Bowl, but just became the luckiest man in the JFW.
Wow. He existed, Nick. And somehow the universe let him win. Well, not win, survive.
Oh, my goodness. But now Nick's still in some trouble here. He needs to recover and get some sort of offense going.
Yep. Yeah, he's still in trouble.
Oh, he's got Kaz! Here it is! Quick counter on Calcium. Sends him as far away from the table as possible. An interesting strategy.
Oh. God.
And now Calcium right back. Calcium much more focused on that table than Gdanek is, other than Gdanek's face almost went through it.
Yeah.
And here we go. Here we go, folks. Look out, Calcium. Or excuse me, Nick. Howdy, no. Nick in trouble. Falls to his feet again. That worked for him last time. Will it work again, though?
And he reverses the whip. Oh, and sends Calcium packing to the outside.
And, folks, there we go. Nick, who likes to get out of, get as far away from the competition as possible when he's playing Blood Bowl, is doing the same thing right now in the JFW, getting as far away from the table as possible. Can't go through it if you're nowhere near it.
Yeah.
Practicing avoidance, a bit of a DACA, if you will.
No one practices avoidance with better than Nick, to be honest. He never faces a common opponent, literally ever.
Well, I know for great certainty that's not true, because he plays in the SFL and he's even won it a couple times, which means he's at least played one competent opponent, and that guy's name is Scaramezzo.
In the CCL.
CCL. The CCL is just a joke now, isn't it? Oh, look out! Oh, Jesus! Nick almost put himself through the table.
He really did. Oh, Unagi!
Another Uranagi! But he's got to get that table set up and put Calcium through it, and he knows it now.
Oh, I think Calcium's days are numbered. I think this is going to be it for Nick.
This could be, and Nick would have, if Nick can win this match, he'll have eliminated all three competitors, and no better way to really, really sign your own contract than that.
Oh, he hasn't broken it!
Table didn't break. Nick is practicing avoidance again. Oh, he wants another table.
Yeah.
Not happy with the one table there. Clearly it was oh god.
Oh god, yeah, that was a shoot table. Now he's got the
Oh no, Nick. Oh no, god. Nick.
What's happening?
Here we go.
This could be it.
Here we go. No. The chop against the table. And Calcium needs to come to his senses here or it's all going to be over just like that. Nick.
Oh god.
He's got him.
He's got him. He's got him.
He's got him up, and he's through.
Oh,
and
my
Nick
God.
Oh, and Nick is joining his tag team partner, Try, in Money in the Ass in 2 weeks' time, folks.
My God. I don't believe it.
Wow, what a comeback by Nick. He did everything just right, practiced perfect avoidance when he needed to, knocking that table out of the way to save the match for himself, and eliminating not one, not two, but all three men himself to win this match and punch his ticket to Money in the Ass.
Wow. Unbelievable. What a performance. Howdy, Nick. I really hope he gets a rework back to G'day Nick soon.
Well, you know, there's nothing like having to face your tag team partner in a desperate attempt to get a contract for a title to maybe want to rebrand yourself a little bit. We will have to wait and see.
Yeah. Right, well, there you go. That was that match.
What a way to start Friday. Stand firm, innovators of wrestling offense always. Great first match, and now trios action. The winner, 3-5 Wheats, are taking on Norse Country.
Boy, howdy, yeah. The
full... Another match that could last ages.
Yeah, this is great stuff. Yep, what can you say? Not the biggest fan of Norse, but you know, it's quite the team, isn't it?
Absolutely. Well, it is definitely Thaw carrying two monkeys on each shoulder.
Yeah.
I'm going to find everyone who plays Norse in real life and just beat them to within an inch of their fucking life.
Oh, dear.
And the winner, 3-5 Wheats, of course, both J5 and Skrull would love another shot at that Money in the Ass contract, or maybe even Wem Dopa right now trying to solidify as a trios team. And of course, Tom Schniz has been on fire recently, winning last week with the Plim Plom Plex and winning the week before. Or no, they actually lost the week in between. But Tom Schniz making a case that he needs to be re-examined for the Plim Plom Pluserweight title. We will see what the future holds there.
Yep. Here we go. Right, let's get to ringside.
Indeed, those loading times seem extra long today.
Yeah, don't they?
Somebody forgot to give them a trio's entrance, baby.
Ah, woo, that's good.
Awesome. Well, there they are, the winner, 3-5 Wheats, entering to some generic-ass music. Because some members of our production team don't seem to pay attention.
Well,
but here they are.
Some members of our production team didn't get any instructions on how to make them for the thing, and so you know, cut them some slack, eh?
Yeah. gotta do everything around here as commissioner. And next up, folks, it is Norse Country.
Yeah.
Entering correctly this time.
Yep. Yeah, the enter correctly is plowing space is correct. And all three is correct. But yeah, unfortunately.
This entrance really highlights the Norse Country strategy of we've got Thaw and not much else.
Yeah, it's really good, isn't it? It's actually perfect.
Thank you. But it does speed Thaw's trip to the ring up significantly, so.
Yeah, that's a good point.
There they are. Norse country. It's more Plovach and Space Cadet trailing Thaw, who is qualified for Money in the Ass, and what an impact he's probably going to make.
Hmm.
Is that because you are also a bad dude, Flicky? And here we go. Thaw and Skuro going to start it off. That is the winner 358 himself and leader of the winner 35 wheats.
Yep.
Well, that didn't go great for him to start, as Thaw showcasing one of the best European uppercuts you'll ever see.
Yep.
8 p.m. UTC on July something.
3rd, I think.
July, yes. 3rd. July 3rd, 8 p.m. UTC.
Yep.
And Thaw really taking it to Skuro off the bat here. Of course, in tag action last week, Johnny Five and Tom Schniz getting the win over two members of Norse country. And in trios action here with Thaw, they're looking to getting some revenge.
Yep. Sorry, I'm shattered.
I can tell. But that's okay, I am too.
Whee!
Skuro with a nice counter here and able to get the tag into J5, get himself a little bit of respite as J5 comes in and immediately walks in into an unfriendly corner.
Boy, howdy.
Oh, look out, J5 getting wound up and shoulder tackled down. Oh no, and like a wishbone, J5 ain't that flexible, folks. He's right back on his feet with a nice uppercut and a big forearm and chop. No, counter by Space Cadet. And right back into the unfriendly corner he goes, into a side Russian suplex. Blah. You know what I mean.
Yeah. Yep.
Oh, double stomp by Space Cadet would, if he weighed anything, would maybe be a little bit more threatening. And coming right back in is Thaw. Oh, cheap shot by Mort Plovach. And now we're in countout territory already, even though the ref hasn't started counting. One of the primary strategies in trios matches is those countout victories.
Yep, just whipping them into the knees over and over again. Vicious maneuver.
Yep, highly sought after combination of attacks there to just throw your opponent into one of your team members, preventing him from getting in the ring, and we are in the danger zone now, folks.
Yep, we're at 6 already.
And here we go. Oh, no. Thaw. Oh, sending him a long way away, though, but he could put him in here. Nope.
Oh,
and Thaw breaking the count.
Unbelievable, isn't it? Very rarely seen.
Thaw. Yeah, Thaw breaking the count. Really wants to inflict harm on the winner 3-5 Wheats. Of course, trying to psych himself up for money in the ass. That could be a turning point for Thaw and Norse country if he were able to get that contract.
Yep.
But he looks like he's going to pay for his hubris as here comes Le Bread Mask, the Friday fuckboy himself, Tom Schniz.
Boy, howdy. Good.
Stomping away is Tom Schniz, wearing out Thaw. They've got him isolated now. Oh, oof. Beautiful moon, standing shooting star press there Tom Schnitz, the high flyer into the self-rock bottom. He might have him right here. We've seen that in matches before. Oh, but J5 went the wrong way, and Moroklovac able to break that up. But spiking Thaw into it, and now certainly Thaw must be regretting not taking that count out win.
There he is. Oof.
Still, though, he's got that bulk and that size advantage running right over Tom Schnitz. But look at this. Look at this. Oh. Into the pin. No, he doesn't hang on for the pin. I think he wanted to tag in J5 there, but J5 wasn't paying attention. So now Tom does not know what to do. Thinking long and hard, really lining up his next attack. He's really got him. He's in the zone there. He's zoning in on him. Honing
it
on him. Into the arc lay. Oh, out of nowhere. Out of nowhere, folks. We didn't see it coming at all. And now looking for the plim-plom plex. What a flurry by Tom. Wouldn't this be something if he could pin the heavy hitter of Norse country?
Oh, space was right on it. Great stuff from Space Cadet. Shockingly.
Yeah, Skuro was both late to the rescue and paid the penalty, and now J5 tagged in here. Huh. And that might have been enough recovery time for Thaw, but look out, J5, no slouch, of course. Former WEMDOPE champion, former tag team champion.
Yep.
And this. Shake, rattle, and roll, neck breaker. We've seen that in matches for J5 before.
Yep.
And he's going to walk Thaw over into the friendly corners. He's going to think about tagging in Tom Schnitz. He is not. What is he thinking here?
Oof.
Oh, hangs him up on the ropes. Thaw is taking a ton of damage in this one. And Skuro finally back up on the apron. Took a long time to get there. J5 controlling Tom Schnitz. And here comes Tom Schnitz. Look at that. Double stomp to the back. Thaw in all kinds of trouble. But he's got the counter in here. Needs to think about a tag out. I think he's thinking about something else, though. Burning hammer.
Oh, boy.
There it is. Look out, Tom.
Oh, killed him.
And the pin in.
They're not coming in.
No,
this could be it.
To his age.
Oh.
Yep, no. The winner, 3-5 Wheats. They had full faith in Tom Schnitz there.
Here we go. Protecting the win. Protecting the pin is super easy.
Yep. Tagging in Space Cadet. Nothing could possibly go wrong here.
I love how skinny Space is.
Yep. And his fucking weird body hair.
Yeah. Perfect.
Oh, big back body drop. Looked like toast coming out of the toaster at high velocity there. Oh, no.
There we go.
Oh, no. And there it is, the Space Cadet March. Tom in some trouble. Oh, Space Cadet changing his mind, maybe going for that awesome elbow drop.
Yeah, the insane elbow, whoosh.
Insane elbow drop. Getting dunked on by Space Cadet. No one's gonna like that, Tom. But easily broken up once again.
Skuro's in.
Yeah, Skuro is in.
He's not doing
all right.
Anything.
Doesn't do a damn thing as Tom Schnitz gets the whirly real neck breaker there. Oh, but look at this. Dragon Screw sweeping the leg there and tagging in J5. And J5 has a significant size advantage on Space and introduces him to the knee and now might be introducing him to the mat the hard way.
Oh, God. He sure is.
And there it is, curb stomp, but space right near his tag team partners. Will this be enough for a pin? Drags him a long way away. No one in to help. Ref!
Oh,
I think he had a three count if the ref had been Johnny on the spot there.
What a shambles.
Indeed. And now just going to work that neck, try and take as much energy out of Space Cadet as he possibly can. Over the top, J5 goes. Where this ends, nobody knows. I don't think Mora Plovac has been the legal man yet in this match.
I don't think he has, no.
Thought he was. All right. The winner 3-5 is just styling over in the corner there. Now Skuro, the legal man, has got space over in the danger corner here. And again, maybe working that count up. Oh, but countered is Skuro, as now he's going to be in some trouble here. Four count coming here. Skuro just teeing off on Space Cadet now. Up to a six count.
Oh, yep, here we go.
Oh,
this could be it.
It's a long count to eight, but we'll see. And
he thinks he's won.
The Skuro thinks he's got it won. And I think he has. Oh, and the winner 3-5s now have two wins in a row against Norse Country. You might not love to see the count out win, but it is perfectly viable in trios action, as the winner 3-5 celebrate with their generic ass music in a big victory here on Friday Stand Firm.
Yep.
Defending the ball is super easy.
Wonderful. Amazing. Yes, absolute pinnacle, exactly.
And there they are, the winner 3-5 Wheats. Surely one of the best trios groups we've got in this burgeoning division on Friday Stand Firm.
Indeed. And now he's just got normal one-on-one matchup. We've got JBG taking on Dimmy G.
Yes, indeed. Dimmy G, of course, who took the pin by JBG at Hell in a Cell to make JBG the champion. But these two had a two-on-one handicap match against Frost Lord Army last week on Friday Stand Firm, and Dimmy tapped himself out in it. JBG not pleased with that result, going one-on-one tonight against Dimmy fucking G.
Let's go. Does the loser give up their G? Yeah, it is JBG versus Dimmy G. It's a good point. The champ coming out first for no apparent reason. Ford. It is non-title. I don't think Among Us is happening, I've got to be honest.
Sorry, what was that? I had to take my headphones off for a second.
I don't think Among Us is happening. Oh, God. I'm shattered. Dimmy!
There he is, Dimmy G.
Don't talk about his balls. His balls are big. I guess you missed that clip earlier, Gorilla.
I did not.
He was really good. He was really serious, and he was like, "Don't question my balls."
I responded with, "If you question his balls, he'll send you a gif of some other dude's balls."
Oh God, yeah. That was a weird gif to send, wasn't it?
Out of nowhere, like we don't talk privately. Just. Oh, hey, Skuro, and he sends me a link, and I click it. I hadn't talked to him in a DM in, like, over a year.
Fucking Dimmy.
And here we go, one-on-one against the champion. Dimmy getting a win here. What is JBG thinking? Maybe not the best strategy. I think JBG thought he was in a yoga session or something. Instead, getting himself superplexed by Dimmy G for really no reason whatsoever. Oh, but maybe he was just baiting him to get that sweet knee to the face.
Oh, fuck some mania. Walking him back to the corner. Good bit of strength from Dimmy the champ. Quiz pit champ that he didn't really win legitimately. Just quietly.
Oh. Oh no! Ref getting taken out on that forearm, and will that come into play as JBG snapping the neck of Dimmy G? Look out, self rock bottom. Dimmy G really putting up a fight here. Maybe thinking if he can pin the champ, he's got as good a claim as everyone but maybe Frost Lord Army to that title.
Mm. Oh, big miss from Dim.
You don't miss those very easily. Oh, this is a soft pin, though. Not even a one count. Yeah, we all saw it, Dimmy. You won with a well over 1,000-point lead over Jim.
Yes. Of course, there were about 30 questions, and I was leading by a mile.
How you get there is irrelevant. It just matters who they call the winner. Believe me, I know. I am the winner 8.
You know better than anyone on that score, yeah.
That's right. Jimmy is the quiz pit champion.
Yep. Oh, wow.
Oh, look at that. Beautiful side suplex. Just a one count. JBG looking to efficiently put away Dimmy. I think he does not want to have to give him any claim to that title by a good performance or even a loss, obviously.
Yep. Oh, big counter.
Indeed, dropping him right on those ropes. Another quick pin. Look at this. Yeah, he's just trying to steal a win here, but he is going to have to do more than that. You might not have seen Dimmy G do a whole lot in the JFW in his time here, but you still have to respect him. Does not have enough brain cells left after all that drinking to really register pain, so he can hang with most people.
Oh, dude. Yeah, and, you know, JBG's a very tactical wrestler. Dimmy's going to have to use both brain cells to win this one.
It is true. And JBG has been dominating in this match, but here comes Demi. He's kind of like Homer Simpson in the boxing episode where he just sits there getting punched in the head until the other opponent gets a bit too tired. Mm-hmm. Oh, look out. What's he thinking here? Oh, look at this.
No, Stratisfaction.
Bulldog. Yeah, Stratisfaction. Springboard Bulldog, they sometimes call it, into the pin. Is that it for the champ? No way.
He's got him. He's done it.
Oh, my God. Demi G just shocked the world. And it's exactly as I called it. He just weathered the storm. Watch JBG drop his guard into that Springboard Bulldog and gets the win. Demi G has just pinned the champ. JBG can't believe it, but you know what? He's still the champ. This was non-title. Extending the hand, and there you go. Both of those men have a bit more to feud with Frostlord Army than they do themselves.
Demi!
And while there might be sportsmanship inside the ring, there certainly ain't in chat.
Get wrecked. Oh, well, there you go. Okay, now we've got the very exciting Plim Plom Pluserweight match.
Oh boy. Plim Plom Pluserweights, folks. This match will add one person to Money in the Ass to compete against Moradam for the Plim Plom Pluserweight Championship. So stay tuned for this one. It is a steel cage, hopefully escape-only match.
It is escape-only, yes.
Oh, thank Christ.
Tragically, no Ansi, that happened too close to kickoff, to adapt.
And I am going to announce now, because we haven't announced it yet, the Plim Plom Pluserweight title match at Money in the Ass will be a triple threat, and it'll be Moradam defending against whoever wins this match and someone who qualifies next week on Friday Stand Firm. So make sure to stay tuned for that. But who's going to climb out of this cage? Will it be Elliot Fiction, fucking Elp Meme, or the Blue Bomber, who came so close to winning himself a title shot 2 weeks ago? Of course, he fell to Z-Talk the day, and Z-Talk then went on, had a title shot against Moradam last week in the main event, and fell short after a pretty stellar showing.
Yep.
Well, I think we can all say definitively we don't need to see the filing gimp on a pay-per-view again. So hopefully this former bird does not know how to fly.
Oh dear. I wonder if he'll ever return to being a seagull again or not.
Who cares?
Who the fuck cares? Brilliant. Not yet, Dr. Funk, not yet.
Nope, Dr. Funk, he's up next, I believe. Marcel McDaniel's in-ring return finally happens next week. Next match.
It's definitely going to happen, though, yep.
I mean, why would you have any reason to doubt us?
Yeah. Oh god, I love it. God, I love the Elliot entrance. This is genuinely great entrance though, isn't it? I think this is amazing.
I agree.
Box Art Mega Man.
Box Art Mega Man. The legend himself. Marcellus Interruptus. There he is, Box Art Mega Man, the Blue Bomber, and he, a high flyer, he might have the best chance to get out of that cage, because it doesn't matter how many pinfalls or submissions you can try and rack up, the only thing that matters is climbing out of that cage in this one.
What an entrance. The duct tape terror.
Yep. I gotta say, I don't know a ton about Fiction personally. His rise to prominence was in my absence, but he is looking to shake up the Plim Plum Palooza-weight division, which has admittedly become a bit stale as of late. Of course, Elk Meme, Blue Bomber making a return, and we all love Elia. These guys, all great competitors in the Plim Plum Palooza-weight championships division. But, you know, we've seen all the big hitters, the Just Joes and the what's his face? Oh yeah. Mm. Yeah, Muppet, of course. And look at that, right off the bat, that rainbow cutter. Well, Fiction over jumping there. Wow, this is chaos already, folks. Point being, it would be nice to see some fresh blood with that title. Of course, Mordam hasn't held it in a long time, and he's got a stranglehold on it right now, just like a stranglehold over someone's balls.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, Elliot, look at this. Everyone's seeming to be fired up for this one. These guys know how big of an opportunity this is. Chaos in the middle of this ring again. All of this for naught. If you can't get up and over, there are no pinfalls, no submissions, no way to win this match other than climbing out of the ring or escaping out that door.
Do you know if it's just the first one over the top wins, or is it like elimination?
First one over the top, unless you added elimination to the stipulation.
I didn't.
It wasn't meant to be. I have a feeling you can't do elimination
right
in a cage match.
Right.
You can only apply it to certain things, and I'm guessing this isn't one of them.
Radio, so the first one to get out will win.
Yep, and it looks like Fiction. Nope, he's not going for the door. Oh, the running punt there to Blue Bomber. Luckily, he's got that safety helmet on.
Yeah.
And it did protect him as he gets the uppercut and gets right back after it. Oh, no. Look at this.
Well,
Elliott looking to escape while no one's
paying
attention.
No,
he's not. Oh, my goodness. Swanton bomb by Elliott. And Blue Bomber's got a chance here if he starts climbing. Oh, look out.
Self rope bottom.
Oh, Elton back to his feet, countering and dropping Blue Bomber. Now trying to climb himself, but Fiction's got him lined up. Don't think he's getting too far. Oh, look at this, though. He might have fought him off. Can he get up another rung? A rung like it's a ladder. It's not. And there's Elliott with the save.
Oof.
Dropping him all the way down. Now Blue Bomber going to try and climb. Elliott, nope. Elliott, right, well focused. Oh, no, maybe not.
Well, yeah.
He looked focused for a minute there. Now Blue Bomber is all the way up.
Oh,
somebody's
my God.
Somebody's going to have to get up there to counter
him. Oh, my God, look at Fiction.
Fiction a little confused. Now Fiction's going to get up there. He might have a chance here to grab him. And he does. He stops him by punching him out of the ring almost.
Yeah, funny that.
And now he's got a good hold on the leg and he's dragging him right back in. And now Blue Bomber in trouble all the way back into the cage. Oh, man, a third one up on the ropes.
Wow.
I don't think we've ever seen three up there.
No.
It's like the fucking Three Stooges here.
It really is.
Who's going to fall? Oh, no.
Oh, Elliot's going on his own!
Elliott applying some logic here while these two duke it out. And now it's going to be a race between Elliott and Elfmeme.
Elliott! Surely! Surely Elliott is going
to
win!
Elliott off the top there. End it all. And there we go! Can he get him?
He's done it!
He's done it! Elliott has done it! Elliott up and over, and Elliott is going to money in the ass. And if only he had Jim unbanned, he could know about his glory.
Yep. Oh, wow.
Elliott with the huge win. The most logical man in this match saw everyone else hung up, eliminating each other from getting up and over, and he just took a different wall. And was uncontested getting up and over and out of the cage.
Yeah, it was great. It was actually great, wasn't it? Brilliant, brilliant win for Elliott.
High strategy that won't really apply when he's in a ball punching match against Wardam in a couple weeks.
That's true. That is true.
He's got that target right there, but can he concoct a way to beat the literal fucking goblin and take that plim plom pluserweight title?
Well, let's hope it doesn't involve using any hands because. Wee. Right, now we've got it. Everyone's been waiting for it. I know I have.
Finally, it's finally time for the Marcel McDaniels Open Challenge. It's been months in the making, folks. It is now finally time for Marcel McDaniels to issue his Open Challenge. Anyone in the back is able to come out and greet him back into the JFW in the ring. Guarantee this one's going down.
Oh man, let's go to ringside.
Indeed.
Oh, what the hell?
And that's not the first time I've guaranteed I'd go down and then come up empty. As Frostlord Army ambushing JBG, who already lost the match to Dimmy G and was clearly still weak. Frostlord Army continuing his tear against his war, if you will, against JBG, who stole, in his eyes, that World Heavyweight Championship from him. And I don't think anything is going to stop him. His utter dominance, he beat JBG in about half a minute. in their first go through, and then beat Dimmy and JBG in a handicap match, and now looking to apply the pain, but the champ is fighting back. He's got to be sick of this.
Yep.
And folks, I am getting word. We've got Marcel in the ring still, but we got to keep the cameras here. That's our champion. That is our flagship bearer. Flagship, whatever. For Friday, Stand Firm. So Marcel McDaniels' match is going to have to be postponed until next week, folks.
Man, that's so sad, isn't it?
I'm really, really sorry to have to do this to you all, but in the interest of the action at hand, we've got to stay backstage here and see the developing situation here between Frost Lord Army and JBG.
Yeah.
Yes, Demi. Oh, look out, JBG. Oh, long way down to fall onto that 14 feet of concrete.
It's funny you should say about the goose, Demi, because... You know, watching Stranger Things, there's the episode where Lucas leads the gang to the wrong place, and Eddie would be a sitting goose there. Hey, thought that was genius.
Really surprised by the fight that JBG's had, and he's already performing better than he did in an organized match against Frostlord.
Yeah.
Actually, I take it back. That wasn't an organized match. JBG was expecting to face Demi G in that first contest, and Frostlord eliminated him from the match. Oh, look out! Oof. Bouncing off that all-too-familiar electrical panel there. And you can just see the frustration in the champ's eyes, even though he's wearing sunglasses.
Oh, yeah, I can see it. Yep.
Oh, what's he got in mind here? Absolutely nothing. Oh, look out, bomb. Though. Good oh. Bomb onto 14 feet of concrete, and you saw Frosty bouncing off that.
Ouch.
Oh, and he's sending him into the commissioner's office. Hello, puppies.
Boom, good cutter. It's not it.
Just got back from a walk, and they're jumping on me.
Oh, dear. I thought the good cut would have got him, it didn't, busted him open. There is a bit of carpet protecting him though from this 14 foot of concrete.
What a heroic performance here by JBG. And
really
now, oh no. Introducing him to that briefcase, of course, not the money in the ass briefcase, because it hasn't been spray painted yet.
I'll spray paint your ass. Oh, Famous are onto the thing.
Oh,
the
my
case.
Goodness. The Famous are directly on to that metal briefcase.
That was incredible. Frostlord. That was actually incredible, wasn't it?
Yeah, the first misstep we've seen in weeks by Frostlord, I think. But here we go. Might not mean anything. Oh.
It might
and
not.
JBG just had nothing left after having that pretty solid match against Demi G. And he's down and out. We're going to get some refs back there to attend to him. Mm. And again, apologies to Marcel McDaniels. You know what? I got something to say here about our surprise main event. So I'm just going to head out to ringside right now and announce it there for the entire JFW universe.
Oh, okay. Well, we've got Gorilla Metzo on his way to the ring. That's very exciting, isn't it? Can't wait to hear what Gorilla's got to say. I've got no idea what he's saying, and not just because I'm incompetent. No, that might be the reason, actually. Let's go to ringside and find out.
Good evening, JFW Universe. Hope you're having a wonderful Friday night. Stand firm with us. I've got a bit to say, and some of it a bit forced, some of it coming from the heart, and it pertains to the WEM Dope Championship. I have been accused by my fellow commissioner of Monday, CAW, Jim McMahon, of gaming the system to ensure that Night Demon and the Plim Plom Plus, excuse me, the WEM Dope Championship stays on Friday Stand Firm. Well, I'd like to just point out that Night Demon is one of the best, most prolific wrestlers in all of pro wrestling, and that's why we still have the WEM Dope title, and no other reason. But I can understand you see me stacking the odds in my favor, and the investment board has come back and told me that at Money in the Ass, it needs to be a fair split for the WEM Dope Championship. So what it's gonna be is a TLC match, six-man TLC match for the WEM Dope title at Money in the Ass. Three from Monday Night CAW and three from Friday Stand Firm. And you know what, folks? Tonight in your main event, our surprise main event, it's going to be Flicky Flack versus Cocky versus Squirrel in a triple threat elimination match to take that first spot. So get ready for the main event. Who is going to join Night Demon and one other person to qualify next week? And who is CAW going to send for that WEM Dope title? We're going to find out next. See ya.
Sorry, I messed up there. Wow, there you go. Triple threat. Cocky, Flicky, and Squirrel Dude. Glorious.
Triple threat elimination match for your main event. I hope it's elimination. Here we go, folks. Cocky, Flicky, and Squirrel Dude.
Yep.
And then Monday Night CAW will have the opportunity to pick three members of their roster to compete in that TLC match against Night Demon, one of these three, and one more person who will qualify next week.
Boy, howdy. Can't wait to see you CAW send as well. That's going to be interesting.
Yep.
Yep.
I think it's all just a big bunch of sound and fury, and it won't amount to much because it's going to be Night Demon walking out of Money in the Ass with that WEM Dope title.
It probably will. He's very hard to beat, isn't he? He's a bit of a legend.
He is. However, he has never been great in those multi-man matches, and he's much better at scoring pinfalls.
Yep.
Well, here he is. He is also a bad dude. It is Flicky Flack. Oh, Flicky. Oh, is he inviting Calcium? No, no, it's his best friend.
It's his best friend, yeah. And he's got his, he's got his glasses on because he's blind, isn't he?
Yeah, we've applied a lot of gimmicks to Flicky Flack, and none of them seem to have made him more interesting.
No, that's true. He just can't beat the music, can he, I think?
Oh, I definitely think you could beat the music.
No, I mean, he can't beat the music.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yes.
Flicking all his friends.
We did see a heroic effort by the other half of Rage Milk, Calcium Kaz, in the show opener, but unable to get the job done in that four-way table elimination match. Gdenek putting him through a table and going on to Money in the Ass.
Yeah. And Cocky only
needs
one gimmick.
One half, yeah, one half of one of the greatest tag teams in professional wrestling history, CBT. It's Cocky. Tag team partner of the Plim Plum Pleaserweight champion, Moradam, would love to get a title around his belt, his waist.
And what a waist.
Hey, yeah, we might have to pop a few holes in it, but I'd say that of most people in the JFW.
So good.
Got a very long forearm.
Yep.
And the big giant nerd himself, Squirrel Dude, is here. Seems like he's always coming up just a little short. Can he win the big one here and then go on to win the even bigger one there? Probably not.
I thought he was crazy, but now I can see his nuts.
Sure is a C-nut. Oh,
big groin.
The last thing you want to do is cross Squirrel Dude, though, when you're supposed to be teamed up with him. That's for damn sure.
He'll certainly tell you to play a game in SFL.
He sure will, or he'll just call you out as the imposter.
Oh my god. I'd totally forgotten that was incredible, wasn't it?
It was so good.
And they hadn't even
it
lost.
Was so good.
The best thing was they hadn't even lost.
No.
Oh god.
And here we go, folks. Triple threat elimination match. Oh! And running right across the ring for the big boot. Cocky a little short there for the intercept. Flicky Flack looking to come alive in this one for the first time in his fucking life.
Wow.
Squirrel knocking Cocky over the top, but he's going to pay for that. Look out, underhook suplex. Yeah, I noticed that, Penimew. Oh, Cocky losing focus. We see that happen all the time in the JFW, and it never goes well for them.
Yep.
Flicky being absolutely dominant right now.
Isn't he just?
But the wind-up counter there. Yeah,
the crowd and the noises are really, really a poor feature of the game, aren't they? Because when they're booing, it just sounds like they're booing the match.
Yep. Yes, indeed. And not like even good booing, just like we're absolutely bored.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, really bad. Oh, wow. Vicious kicks from Squirrel. Oh, and now Flicky, they're both going cocky here.
Squirrel Dude really holding his own against these two. But that might change as those two just took it to Squirrel Dude.
Brian Ebersole.
He's some comedian. Yeah. Ah, yes. He's some comedian from Australia.
Some comedian? He's bloody Crocodile Dundee.
No.
He is.
Oh, Paul Hogan. Yeah, yes. Mm. But that, I mean, the character I meant.
Yeah.
Wasn't probably, yeah. Yes, it is Paul Hogan, yes. Although I had forgotten that.
Yeah. Arthur Dunga.
That's the one.
If you want to see the training video of Cocky, there it is. It's a pretty good video. Sheila's in it.
Well, look at this, into the calf crusher. Will we see an elimination here? Will it? No, he elbows his way out of it. Calf crusher on that man's very skinny calves, probably not going to be super effective. Oh, look out though, running power slam onto Squirrel, smartly rolling out of the ring, avoiding the pinfall. Cocky going to take one instead.
Oof.
Two count, but he kicks out and stays alive.
Can't see past Flicky winning this one, to be honest. He's dominating, isn't he?
I do agree. Flicky has got to be considered a favorite in this match. But, you know, Squirrel Dude can find a way to win in matches like this. We've seen it before. He usually does a lot better in these than the one-on-ones. Well, he just had to miss wildly and fall on his face as I was complimenting him. Brian Nerd. Oh, well, uh-oh. He's going to take a Shattered Dreams, I think.
Uh-oh.
Flicky letting this one happen.
Oh, wow. Cocky alert.
Cocky knew what was coming. Oh. Rakes the eyes.
Boosh.
Oh, the koala kick. Is that it?
It could be.
The pin.
Oh,
2.5 count kick out. I thought Flicky was done there for a second.
Yeah.
And Cocky coming alive in this one. Flicky in all sorts of trouble. Squirrel again smartly rolling out of the ring. Another pinning attempt here. Just a one count there. Maybe should have thought about doing some more wrestling to Flicky after failing to pin him the first time.
Yeah, maybe. Oh, God.
The force on that lariat.
Oh, my God. Nearly got the pin.
Not enough to put Cocky away. I thought it was for a moment.
Mm. Oh, wow.
And this is anyone's match right now. Everyone taking a ton of damage. If anything, Squirrel might be the freshest guy in the ring.
Mm.
That looks like it might be about to change. Maybe not, though. Look out, Cocky. Ooh. Oh, and Squirrel might have Flicky here. Winds him up into that gut buster. Is he going for the pin? He's not. Oh, top rope. We don't see him go to the top rope often.
We don't.
Squirrel, what's he got for him?
High risk.
Oh, boy.
Wow.
And he hangs on for the pin. That might do it.
Oh.
Corkscrew moonsault, and somehow Flicky still kicks out.
A cheeky kick to the nuts from Cocky. Oh, wow, beautiful drop.
Wonder where you learned that one from, huh?
Yeah.
Squirrel with that beautiful drop kick and going for the pin on Cocky. Two count kick out again. What a match we've got in our main event of Friday. Stand firm.
I mean, Cocky's been too beaten up here, isn't he? He's already getting two counters from just nothing moves. This is real bad for him.
Looked like he had another koala kick in him for a second there, though. Mm. Instead, Flicky gonna eat him.
Oh, the big Grian powerbomb.
Yeah, the big Grian powerbomb. But he can't get the pin.
No.
Flicky might have just been spared an elimination there.
Oh, God.
Pile driver. Now, suddenly, just like that, it looks like Cocky could take both men out of this match real quick.
Yeah, doesn't it just...
Well, not like that either.
No. Oh, the double team.
Oh, no. Oh, no. But again, Squirrel rolling out of the ring very wisely. That is a game-winning move right there.
Really is.
And here comes a pump hand. No, pump handles fall away suplex. Into a pin, that's got to be it for Cocky.
Probably is. No.
No, another two count kick out. Squirrel back in the ring now. Maybe would have taken a few more minutes outside of the ring, to be honest.
You would think so, but he just wants to do this, I guess.
Yeah.
Whoosh.
Oh, my goodness. What a maneuver there into a sidewalk slam. He's got to pin him, though.
Yeah, got to pin.
He's going to just wrench that neck a little bit. And he's right into Cocky's face. Look at this. Squirrel dude. Freshest legs. He's had the best strategy coming into this match. And he's got a huge advantage right now.
Oh, my God.
Another two count kick. What he doesn't have is maybe the resilience of Flicky on lock here. Flicky back to his feet. Countered by Squirrel.
No, the roll.
He's going to go for another calf crusher. Is he going to tap? No, he gets right out of it. Never got him a chance to set it up there. Whoa, look out. Jackknife. And just like that, all momentum could be lost for Squirrel, who rolls out again. And the lariat almost eliminating Cocky, who somehow kicks out and stays in it. Quick counter to Flicky. I think the next power move to either of these two, which is this koala kick,
this
could be the deciding factor here.
He's done it.
And that is it. Flicky, the favorite, is out first, and it's down to Cocky versus a slightly fresher Squirrel. Squirrel with a big Ryan power bomb. And this is it.
He's
Squirrel's
going
to money in the ass.
Yes.
It is. Squirrel has been added to the TLC match for the WEM Dope title. Take notes, Night Demon. You know who your first of five other opponents is going to be. It's Squire L. Dude himself. Had a great strategy in this one.
It's horrible, isn't it, just watching Shattered Dreams, even
I know. Though
it's not real. It's like, oh, God. The Moradam ball shots as well, just sometimes just like, oh, God.
What a win for Squirrel, dude. We've seen him win these kinds of matches before. He has yet to truly seal the deal. But can he win a six-man TLC match to keep the WEM Dope title right here on Friday? Stand firm. Find out in 2 weeks on July 3rd at 8 p.m. UTC for Money in the Ass. And next, we've got on Monday Night Claw more qualification matches to come. Stay tuned for that Monday, 8 p.m. UTC as well. Folks, that's going to do it for Friday night. Stand firm. As always, my name is Gorilla Mezzo. Thank you so much for having me.
Glorious. Thank you so much, Gorilla. Thanks for watching, everyone. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. And stay fantastic.